A very, very good evening to each and every one of you for joining our webinar today. The MLF is the social entrepreneurial wing of the MCCI. And we've really tried in the past few months to organize events that give our members exposure and also opportunities for self-development. Today's event is another facet of that. In a world full of cutthroat competition at every stage, it's really important to stand out. I'm going to just pause and welcome Vivek Ji, the MCCI President. Thank you, Vivek Ji, for joining our webinar today.
Please continue, ma'am. I'm just here to provide moral support. That's all.
Thank you.
I just want to thank you, Vaijanti Ji. Vaijanti Ji, you keep supporting MCCI programs with your content.
Thank you so much, Vivek Ji. I'm totally honored. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Pansi, doing good job. That's all. I just wanted to, no point interfering. Please, Nigda, continue. Just wanted to say a quick hello, namaskar, and thank all of you for supporting MCCI by doing these content and programs. May your tribe grow. May your programs grow. That is all we hope for. Thank you once again. Please continue. I'll be signing up. Yeah. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Thank you so much.
So in a world that's full of cutthroat competition at every stage, it's important to really stand out. How does one do that? Personal branding is a tool that can help you no matter your age, profession, or stage in life. But do you think personal branding can be a daunting task? And where do you start this journey? Our speaker today is a friend, fellow committee member of the MLF, and a very accomplished individual. Vaijanti Pugalia Ji is the founder of Sonalis Cubo, a multi-award winning social entrepreneur, life skill architect, profound speaker, and contemporary poet, working extensively to influence the community. She is also the founder of iCubo, a platform for mentoring and exhibiting the skills and creativity for children, and also the president of Life Skills Council of West Bengal. Vaijanti Ji has been awarded the Times Power Women 2019 trophy and has also won the first position in VPitch, Women Awaiter Kolkata platform. Her tailor-made workshops on communication, networking, brand building are very well received by corporates, women and children. We welcome you warmly, Vaijanti Ji, and look forward to a very knowledgeable and engaging session with you today. Thank you so much for sparing.
Thank you, Snigdha Ji. This is a total honor for me and to be, of use to my MLF platform and to be at service again for MCCI is always that I'm looking out for. It's my pleasure. Thank you to you and Mansi. Both of you are doing commendable work in the times that we are in now to promote such varied topics that you're coming up with. And yes, I'm very excited for today. So thank you for having me.
Thank you. So let's, begin this talk. And I think something that as basic as what is personal branding? Can you tell us what it means?
So, Snigdha Ji, personal branding. First of all, I would want the viewers to understand that personal branding is not your corporate branding. It is totally different from what your product or your service is. Over here, when I'm talking about personal branding, I'm talking about the relationship that you have with yourself, which is existing in front of others. It is like a process where you find your uniqueness and you build over it. And that is what people make of it and see you as. And later on, if you are a working professional or an entrepreneur, you can use it to monetize it. Very simply put, it is your reputation. The reputation that you want to put out there so that others would want to invest in you. Invest not monetarily, but primarily they would want to, invest in you, to work with you, to befriend you, to consider you to be dependable. So, all our lives we are running around, as to what we know and whom we know. But the other side of it, it should be how many people know us, and then double it by, trying to understand as to what they know about us. So what do they talk about us when we are not there in the room behind our back? our reputation. And everything in life depends upon this personal brand, which is your reputation. So yes, you know, Slikdaji, very simply put, we have to understand that in order to be, you know, considered as a person who is worthy enough to work with, it is important that we first upgrade our personal brand. As I just said lately, it is personal, just at ITY, it's your personality that needs to be worked on, and that is your personal brand.
Very nicely explained, Vijayanti ji. Is it really applicable in personal life? I mean, you know, on the personal front, how can one be conscious about their brand image?
So, Srikdaji, personal brand, it is like a trademark. You know, it is like your patented product that you have control on. So, you know, we are always remembered in our personal space. So when I'm talking about personal space, I'm talking about your inner circle, your friends, your family. So it is from here that you start building up your brand, your personal brand. So you're always remembered as, you know, to what you endorse, what you say, your actions, your reactions, and then the ramifications that happen around it, the side effects of whether you are breaking a relation or making a relation. Everything depends upon all of these attributes which result in your personal branding. So what is expected of you is what you have to understand when it comes to your personal space and a personal brand, and then act accordingly. You know, in certain cases, it is seen that we expect it from others, but we don't realize what is expected of us. And our concentration is what is being delivered to us rather than what we are offering. So in order to create and optimize your personal branding in a personal life, it is very important to, you know, first make yourself out there, put yourself out there, you know, to with the different tools that, you know, I would like to tell you right now is, you know, how you can do this, you know, wherein you put in your beliefs, your interests, all up in front so that people know of what you are. Signature, have you ever wondered that in a family or in a group of friends, we sometimes look up to certain people, you know, if they are endorsing a cook, if they are endorsing a singer. So we say, you know what, if this person is endorsing it, that person has to be awesome. We don't even question, you know, that the charges are too high or that person is so new to us. We just follow the suggestion that comes to us blindly. Have you try to just uncover that as to why that is happening, that is coming from a space because you have made yourself dependable, which might be consciously or unconsciously. But what is the outer ramification of it is that people depend on you. So even in personal space, you know, if you might be having certain people who are younger to you in age, in family, but the family members are looking at that person to endorse ki ye gaadi khareedni hai, ki wo gaadi khareedni hai, or this color should be there or that color. So that is how that has come about. Just give it a thought. The other person is older, maybe more educated, maybe more versatile. But when it comes to taking the final call, it is the other one who's taking away the show. So this all comes from the space of personal branding. And now I'm sure you would want to know as to in a personal connect, how we can build this. I would like to give my example in it. When it comes to personal branding, I always believe in personal relation, you should be available. You know, you should be dependable. You should be endorsing people in your life. If they're doing good, you must be there to support. If friends are opening new businesses, you must be there to support. And support doesn't mean that you need to do it monetarily. You can help them with contacts. You can share their work. You know, you can give them feedback about their work. All of this comes from the space where, you know, you want to cater to maintaining that relationship. One very, very important thing, Snigdaji, is to look into the control of your voice and your tone in a personal relationship, in terms to your personal branding, how you are talking to people, what your voice is. All of that really makes a lot of difference in case you want to uplift a relation or break it down. If you're talking to your senior, if you're talking to your colleague, if you're talking to your junior, there has to be, you know, a lot of circulation of tones and voice, which adds, you know, to that personal branding. So I would like to just say that you have, whatever you do, you have to be consistent, honest, be out there, know what your thoughts and beliefs are. You know, before you give, before you take, you must be, you know, in a position to give. And that is what makes your personal brand stronger when it comes to a personal space. And most of it is also reflecting in our professional work. But right now, as we are trying to figure out how a personal branding helps, you know, in terms of a personal relationship, it is basically, you know, from the time that we are born with an identity of our name. But on a personal space, how we garnish that name and how we put our beliefs, our thoughts, and we work around that is what the personal branding comes up around. And trust me, it evolves. It's not that, you know, you have your beliefs and your endorsements now at the age of 20. So you will, you can not have something else at the age of 25. But the word out there is being honest to it, honest to the relations, to the people that you have in your life, to be consistent and sustainable with your thoughts with them. And that is what is going to uplift your personal branding in your personal space.
Absolutely, couldn't agree more. And your point about references, I think we look for referrals in anything that we do. Right from hiring, you know, maybe a home staff to making the biggest decision. Once we have a reference backing us, which is reputation based, then we are confident.
That's exactly. And that is what personal branding is. And if I'm blindly following you, what am I investing in you, Snigdhaji? I'm investing my faith in you. And faith is big. Faith is very big. And I'm able to invest that faith in you is because you are able to make an aura around yourself, which gives me the word dependable. I can count on you. And that's the reason why I would want to invest with you in my faith. So, you know, friends, I would say that in a personal space, whenever we can support our friends and family, we should just not support them by staying quiet. Do it through texts, do it through WhatsApps, do it through a phone call. If it's special occasions, nowadays WhatsApps, the social media plays such, makes us so lazy that, you know, we just randomly just send them a message and we don't even bother to pick up the phone and wish them. No, a personal brand starts to work when it is more personal, when it is more intimate. And you can do that when you just pick up that phone, trust me. You have wonderful packages these days, so you don't have to invest much monetarily. Pick up that phone, wish that person good. If that person is going through a crisis, talk to that person in his or her own space by showing her support. The whole conception is that don't follow, you know, what the herd is following. Oh, I'm too busy, so let me just drop down a text. Let me just message, you know. Add that personal touch. This is what makes your personal space very profounding. You know, Snigdhaji, I would like to mention the celebrity here, you know, Mr. Amitabh Bachchan. So yes, you must have heard whenever there is a new movie which is releasing of a person. So I amongst all the tensions which is going on politically right now about getting new stars and the nepotism, I want to keep everything aside. And right now I'm just talking very general. There are a lot of old stars who would send bouquets and best wishes to, you know, the new stars who come into the market. Why do they need to do that? They need to do that because they come out of their personal spaces to make themselves visible and dependable. So these are a few things that we must also try and incorporate, you know, on special occasions, on birthdays. Be there, be available, be dependable, communicate. That is, networking is just not for professionals. Networking is also very important in your personal life.
Absolutely. So taking a cue from what you just said, a lot of us would like to work on our personal brands also, because, you know, we may be entrepreneurs, we may be professionals doing something, you know, in terms of a career. So how does one, you know, make the personal brand become a direct positive influence on that aspect? What are the steps that you can take?
You mean professionally, if you're an entrepreneur or you have a service or you have a product. So as I always say, that we are always born with a brand. The moment we are born, firstly, we have a biological brand, whether we are a girl or a boy. And then comes the names which the parents have already decided, that ladka hua to ye, ladki hui to wo. So yes, and so we have the identity in place, we have the name in place. Now comes the time when the ball is in our court, and slowly by slowly over the years, we build it and take it to a level where, you know, we are developing that identity and we are functioning every day with a conscious effort to build it in our capacity. I think there's so many things that one can do when it comes to, you know, upgrading that personal branding. But I would like to say a few things through examples which I have used in my life. When it comes to personal branding professionally, and you want to excel your personal branding so that it can be monetized for your work, it is very important to be, you know, firstly, like a sponge. Be like a sponge from wherever the knowledge is coming, whatever the knowledge is coming, what you can, you know, sort of relate to. Not that you just take all the chunks into your mind, but if any subject interests you, if there is any subject which is new, you should be open to receiving it. And that is where the first trick lies, is that you have to be a sponge. Don't just tell yourself, you know what, now I'm done. I know about this topic a lot. I might just, you know, be the best in this area. The first rule of a personal branding is, you know, keep learning, keep growing. And for that, you need to be like a sponge. That's very, very important. Second, I would like to move on again, you know, after saying again the words of consistency and sustainability. Now, consistency and sustainability is just not environment prone. It also, you know, is very relevant when it comes to your personality. How consistent you are in situations, which depicts in your personality. When there is work pressure, when there is deadlines to meet, when you have something happening which is not happening according to your terms. So, you know, what are the kind of decisions that you are taking? All of these life skills come under the heading of, you know, your consistency at work. It's not like each day you come with a different temperament at work and people just don't know how to connect to you, because then they would just be so confused that they would not want to work with you. They would be probably too guarded to open to you in terms of receiving any service from you or believing any product that you're selling. So it's important to be consistent and sustainable in the situations that life puts you in. And for that, how you start that, you have to access within yourself as to what is that I believe in, you know, which actually comes through practice, which actually comes slowly by slowly through the different interests in your life that you build, which make you stronger. Finding your weaknesses, not being you know, downed about the weaknesses or the places where you have not achieved success, leaving that behind, picking up the quotes from there and working on. You know, friends, it is very important to understand that your relevance at your work is your personal brand, which is going to be endorsing your commercial brand. So, Sridharji, let's talk about one brand called Amul. Look how Amul takes all of these life skills and life situations that keep happening and multiplies it into their branding. How personal they get into people's spaces with current affairs. So it's like when you look at the brand Amul, you think, oh, this is like my family member. It's like the way I would talk to you about current affairs, that, you know, this celebrity got married or this havoc has taken place. I see the same, you know, channel which is taking place at Amul. So these are a few things that we need to understand, that in order to build our professional brand, we have to believe our personal brand affects our corporate branding. What are our beliefs? What are our thoughts? Are we dependable? What is the X factor that I have which can be accelerated? Now, I might be selling the same product as you, Snigdhaji, but why would then people come to me and not you? So for that, I have to show them my honest face. I have to show them why I have built this brand that I have built this brand with. They have to connect to my empathy and my thoughts. You know, it is business doesn't just run, on the numbers and on the mind. Most of it also works, through your heart. When we are investing in any shares, it is actually proven through statistics. It is our mind frame at that particular time that makes us invest in that particular share. And how does all of this come? This all comes from that belief and that thought and that consistency, that dependence, that sustainability, which we make over the years through personal branding. One very important thing is that with personal branding, you have to create that space where people look up to you. That doesn't mean that, you think that, you are there and no one can be above you. One very important thing that pulls maximum of the companies down is when they reach a space and they think that now no one can come beyond us. So this feeling overpowered is something which your personal brand should never reflect. You should always be full of humility in order to be approachable. Have mentors, for each and every person to have mentors is very important when it comes to your personal brand. Now, mentor doesn't need to be, you have to have a physical mentor. You can always have in form of books, in form of websites, in forms of blogs and articles. Anything that makes you shift to a positive direction is your mentor. So to have mentor at each stage in your life is very important for personal branding. Remember, at the end of the day, it is not how many people it is how many people who know you. What you are trying to depict to them is not important. What is important is what they see of you. And that can only be possible when you are conscious about how you have put outside there. So these mentors are going to teach you to not create the difference, but be the difference. Again, professionally speaking also, your tone of voice really matters. Are you speaking to your colleague? Are you speaking to a student? How are you communicating with your elders? What is the hierarchy of your voice? Remember, friends, in a service industry or in a professional line of a product, or if you are at a seat of power, remember to have empathy and is to build your personal brand. To have a soft tone is to build your personal brand. It is very, very important to tune down that. Most of the people, I'll give you an example. There is a store next to my place where the person who is handling the products there is very rude. There's so many people who stop going there because the person is considered to be totally out of the circumference of communication. So they would walk that extra mile to go to that another store, but they would not want to go to that person. How is it possible? It is possible only because your tone matters. So after consistency and sustainability, the hierarchy of your tone, mentors, I think in a professional capacity, when it comes to your personal branding, another thing, Signaji, which is very important is to be visible. It is very important to be visible. And friends, I would like to mention specifically in the time that we are in right now, where everything is happening so digitally, to be visible in the right spaces on the internet is going to be really personal branding you. What are the pictures you're putting out there? What are the thoughts you're endorsing? How are you communicating with people digitally? All of that is going to be mattered and taken into account, because trust me, people are judgmental. So the moment you are out there, on this world of net, nothing can be taken back. So in your personal and professional life, it is very important to understand that what you're endorsing on the social media is to be looked into account. Everything, right from your pictures, to your thoughts, to your comments, to your compliments, please be very conscious. Don't think that holding a whiskey glass in your hand and being in a place where probably you should not be. I'm sorry, I'm talking about a personal space, but sometimes it do have ramifications. So it's very important to be very conscious about your image, what you're putting out there on the social media. Your digital etiquettes, whether how you're using your emails, how you're using your WhatsApps, how are you appearing on a video conferencing, all of this adds to your personal branding when it comes to your professional branding and helping your professional brand grow. So yes, it is very, very important to understand that these are a few pointers that one should keep in mind when you're trying to build your personal brand professionally. Signaji, towards the end, I would like to mention this one very important thing which most of the people forget, which I mentioned a little earlier, was that whatever you are, please be original. Don't do something that anyone else is doing, because that is not going to add to your personal branding. Don't be a copycat. Be an original, because that is going to trigger positive comments, positive compliments coming towards your end. Live your brand. If you're endorsing sustainable product, if you're endorsing Made in India, if you're endorsing the woolen industry, if you're endorsing any particular area of service of work, live that. Show it in your life. Build around a storytelling around your life, which is going to depict your personal brand, which is on the other hand going to connect to your corporate brand. So what you are offline and what you are online together put is your personal brand, which affects your professional brand. So in case you think that if I'm making the top-notch product, or I'm giving the best service in this particular field, people would come to me. No, they would first want to find out what is your credibility, and then they would come to you. So you have to understand that building your brand online and offline together is what is going to create your personal brand and which is going to help you monetize it.
Very, very lovely ideas, Vijayanti ji, especially around social media and being original. I think, for all the teenagers who joined our webinar today, these are lessons for life. Originality is what takes you far. So what else, all about personal branding do children need to keep in mind specifically?
Yes, very, very important. And I'm very glad that you brought up this question, because, most of the parents and, even the students, children think that we don't need personal branding. We are not yet out there seeking for jobs. We are here in school. Later on, we're going to apply to a university or a college, and then our life is going to start. You are in a big myth, my dear little friends. Let me ask you, how many of you know Dennis Ritchie? Very, very few people would be knowing Dennis Ritchie, whereas Dennis Ritchie and Steve Jobs, both of them died in a gap of 3 days only. But we would remember Steve Jobs, but we would not remember Dennis Ritchie, the man who gave us Microsoft Windows, the man who actually taught us how the computer system runs. But we would remember Steve Jobs. So have you ever wondered why is it that a person who was so mega as Dennis Ritchie is not remembered comparatively to Steve Jobs? Yes, you are right. Before me saying the answer to you, it is all about personal branding. It is the way Steve Jobs has put himself out there by making his thoughts, his ideas, his personality totally transparent and in sync with his product of being simple, of being trendy, of being modern, of being approachable, of being usable. So all of these things that we see in Apple, we would see it in Steve Jobs when he goes up on that stage and he starts talking in that simply tucked t-shirt and jeans. So that is the kind of persona that he built about himself. So yes, Stignaji, a very, very important question. That is, why do children need personal branding? So children definitely need to consider personal branding from a very, very young age. So why do we need personal branding? I've been saying that need it to differentiate us from others. So, it is as important as your essay that you need to apply to get into a college or a professional job. The competition for admissions is crazy. Are you aware that Harvard rejects over 200 applicants a year with a perfect 2400 SAT score? So how is it possible? What is the format of rejection, you know? So this is the reason why you need to build that personal brand both inside and outside. Your simple test scores, your essays, your applications, the way you fill out your form, all of that is not enough. You have to understand that what is your uniqueness. And from a very young age, like maybe from class 6 or 7, you start taking the small steps to build that personal brand. So children can have small-term goals and long-term goals. And at this age, I would prefer that they work more on the small-time goals, you know. So, they have to understand what are the things which interests them. And so their careers have not yet begun. So they have to take in a lot of skills and a lot of experiences. But, you know, Snignaji, where we go wrong, most of us parents, we push our children, you learn this and do that workshop. Again, that herd community. We never sit with our child, help that child to understand the likability that he or she has towards certain engagements in his or her life. And that is from where the personal branding starts, you know, where we as parents should understand and sit with our children and help them analyze what are their interests, what do they want to do in life, which can change. They are young, they are children. It's not that what they think at class 6 is something that they have to keep at university level, but then support that, because that is something which is going to help them build that portfolio and create that confidence, you know. So let's be fair, they are children. So we can't push them, but yes, we can sit and talk to them and make that understand that the way the workforce is going to be tomorrow is very IT based, very robotic. There's going to be very few people in later years who would be seen getting the right jobs and turning out to be successful entrepreneurs, you know. So it is very important to, in order to gauge the future, they start working from now, you know. So they have to understand again what the USP is, how they can evolve, and once explained to them, they would understand, you know. Because, you know, with children's technology, it is very different to make them understand that Converse shoes can never make a higher performance shoe like a Under Armour. Okay, so we cannot tell them that, you know, believe in Twitter and don't believe in Snapchat. They actually need to be talked very smoothly and very subtly, and kids are kids after all. So, you know, we have to be fair to them. But we have to explain to them that just getting your SAT scores in place or, you know, your board exams in place is not enough. So if there is a child who has certain interests in a particular field, from a very young age, understanding whom we can choose as mentors, what can I read to incubate that knowledge, where can I get that knowledge from, with whom can I interact, how can I build on that particular interest, is something, you know, which should be really built by parents and educators sitting together. Because trust me, the competition is very, very, very strong.
Yes, as a mother, I mean, I go through some stress at some point thinking about those things. And like you rightly said, I mean, I never thought that a blog can be a mentor, but yes. Just, you know, redirecting your child's focus. And even when they're reading, you know, picking up the positivity and, you know, encouraging them in whatever they feel that they want to do. I think that's when the personality also starts developing.
Yes, you know, Signature, it's very simple. Why do we always have to give a physicality to a mentor? There are books, there are blogs, there are articles, there are pictures, you know, there are quotes. Life itself, nature, everything is a mentor. It is up to you how you take it to that level, that what am I learning out of it and what am I giving back to it is what you should always be conscious about. So I always tell people, don't look out for mentors in terms of physicality, person A or a person B, anything that you know, makes you in a thinking space is a mentor.
And this is evolution, right? Today, if I tell my teenage nephew that go and meet somebody and get some advice from him or her, he might find the idea a little hilarious. But whereas if I tell him that look at five blogs that interest you and pick up the best parts, I mean, he will relate to that very easily. So I think as parents, we need to evolve as well, surely.
It is very important. And that's the reason I always say, please stop following that herd community. If I'm strictly speaking this personal branding space in regards to children, where most of the parents, they push their children to learn certain skills or be a part of certain clubs, just because probably the child who is getting very good marks in class has joined it. Please understand the potential, what your child has, and develop on that brand, because that is what is going to yield results and not otherwise.
So, Vaijayanti ji, what are the typical myths around personal branding, you know, which one should not think that, you know, overcome those in your mind?
Personal brands. Oh, there are so many myths. I can't tell you. I think the one most common myth is that personal brands are fake. So they are invented or they are created. So yes, those personal brands which are sugar-coated in their packaging are definitely fake. Which brands are sugar-coated? So today, Stigdaji, if I come across a person to you and I try and depict a persona about myself, trust me, if I'm fake, I will not be consistent. This is a human error, you know. At the end of the day, we are not machines that if we program something, we're going to work accordingly. Every day, our temperature in the body, the pressure of outside, our mind, our DNA, every day, the way we react to the situation is different, okay? So today, if I come up to you with a created, okay, personal branding, you would gauge me on the third day or the fourth day that I'm not a genuine person and there is no consistency about me. I just act as the way the atmosphere is. So personal branding, the biggest myth is that it is created and invented. No, it is built. Those personal brands which are invented, sugar-coated, created, they are not the brands which are evolved. And I'm talking about brands in case of your personality. And no human being is stupid. You would be able to gauge that. So one of the myths of personal branding is that it is created and invented. No, personal branding evolves over time. It takes a lot of conscious effort. And definitely it's not for fake. Another myth about personal branding, that it is only for the people who are outspoken. Like today I'm talking, or Signaji, you're not camera shy. So it's for us. We can brand ourselves and we can go out there and we can conquer the world. No, personal branding is also for the introverts. So imagine, and I'm surely in a space to ask you this, Signaji, don't you think the people who are introverts, they are more self-conscious? They are more drawn inwards, so they know themselves more because their whole focus,
their behaviors, and everything.
Yeah, because introverts are more conscious about themselves. So it is a very big misconception that personal branding is not for introverts. So friends, if you think that you are not the one who speaks a lot, or you are camera shy, or you don't have the confidence, trust me, you will be the best personal brand executive there, because you know yourself the best. You know what are are your pluses are, what are your minuses are, and you can work on it. So it's an added advantage. So the second biggest myth about personal branding is that it is only for the outspoken ones and not for the introverts. And I totally don't resonate with this particular point. And the third is that personal branding makes you egoistic. So when does it make it egoistic? If I'm going on talking about myself, if I keep bragging about myself, that is when it appears to be egoistic. If you are very clear with your beliefs, your endorsements, your storytelling, then if you're talking about it and you're consistent, remember, if you're honest, if you're transparent, then no one can ever say that, you know what, this person is very egoistic and everything that this person does is very self-obsessing. Who are the people who are self-obsessed, who are egoistic, and who actually don't understand personal branding and who think that just talking about themselves in every meet with their friends, with their peers, with the, you know, with the hierarchy, with the subordinates, if they go on and on talking about themselves, that's when it sounds egoistic. Otherwise, it is just simple brand building. And one very important misconception about personal branding is that it competes with the corporate branding. And remember, throughout my talk, friends, I've been saying that personal branding supports your corporate branding. When all your employees of an organization, you yourself, you are clear with your strengths, with your focus, with your beliefs, what you want to put out there, what you're feeling inside through your product, through your behavior, right from the peon of your office to the highest position in your office, the person, if you all are depicting the true nature of who you are, then you're building your corporate brand. See that when you go to someone's office and you see that the peon comes so politely and tells you, would you like to have some water, offers you tea while you're waiting, well, then that person must be just a peon, not even like a sub officer at that place. You already have this thought process in your mind before going and meeting the person with whom your appointment is, you know what, that I'm at the right place. So this is all your personal branding. So yes, another very big myth is your personal brand never competes with your corporate branding. In fact, it supports your corporate branding. So yes, these are a few myths, I think, which upsets me about personal branding, and I thought I must share with you.
In fact, I think, the founder typically, who is the face of the organization, his or her brand is synonymous with the organization's brand image.
Absolutely.
When I look up to a particular person and I know, okay, this is his or her company, I would be very okay, dealing with that company, knowing that it is being led by this person.
Absolutely. Absolutely. In very simple way, I can just say, Stignaji, it's a crazy energy for me this year to be a part of MLF because you are leading it as a chair. Your personal brand definitely endorses the MLF this year. A very simple example to put through.
Thank you always for being a big support. So I wanted to ask you that, is building a personal brand a very hard task? I mean, what are the steps that one can take in this regard to start with?
So I think it is only a hard task when you're trying to be someone whom you're not. So the moment you are who you are and you let people know who you are, whether you believe in pop music or the Hindustani classical, whether you eat non-veg or you eat veg, whether you are made in India or a total foreign bhaisa, whatever it is, you like Indian authors or English authors, whatever you are, if you put it all out there, transparent, trust me, it's not a hard work. You need to put in hard work only at something which you are not. So if you are, spreading yourself too thinly, then I can say that, yes, it needs a lot of hard work because you're trying to be someone whom you are not. But if you are original, if you are brand new, then there is no hard work. It is just swift flowing water.
So rightly said. And there's an interesting question in the chat window I've been waiting to ask you.
Right.
Wouldn't it be boring to be so correct in everything, from Mr. Sunil Bhandari?
No, that is where the spark is, where, so you can be correct at different places, right, Sunilji? So, zaruri nahi hai that you need to be perfect at only one thing. So, the people who know me, they know I can sing well, I can dance well, I can talk well, I can teach well, I can curate well. So, does that mean boring? I'm sure the people who know me, they know me as a most colorful person, and I'm able to do that, A, I think just being myself, by bringing variety. And how can I bring variety is, again, being conscious about the knowledge around me, by open to learning new things, whether it is culture or art or any form of business. So yes, the idea is not that if you are perfect is going to build your personal brand. The idea is just you need to be true to it. Even if you're not perfect at it, it's fine. Just be true to it. If you're mediocre also, but if you're true to it, that's your personal brand.
I had a question, Vajanti ji. Suppose, because you've spoken in depth about the tone and, the way you're saying something, even though the intent may be good, but your delivery may be flawed. And so maybe a person has sort of burnt some bridges, on a personal branding front. So is it like the battle has been lost, or can that person turn around and, again, revive their personal brand and come out as a more positive person?
I would just say one thing, always ask yourself, do you actually want it? Do you want to go back to it? Would you be able to give a part of you to it or take some part of it back into your life? And if you have any answers which comes in affirmations, I don't think that as a human being, as a powerful human being with a rational mind, revisiting that space is not correct. Because somewhere in your subconscious, if you're thinking of going back to it, that means that need, that desire to get back to it is already there. What is stopping you is probably your ego, or that what would the person in front react to. But won't it be just good to do over and up with it if you just revisit it, try and work on it again, and if still doesn't work it's fine. But I always say, and I've always done this in my life, and the people who are close to me, they know, I work till the last drop in the ocean to make that relation work or make that thing work. Even if I need to myself go forward 100 times, I don't let ego come that, why should I go 100 times? Your personal brand is this uniqueness, which gives you that strength to understand that what is more important? Is it your ego, or is it that person whom you want back in your life, or that job back in your life, or any particular thing back in your life? So the idea is that you have to ask yourself, how badly do you need it? And then go for it.
Such an important lesson, that one. Something that we all really have to learn with time, I guess.
No, I think I don't let things go so easily if I put my heart and soul to it. And only when I know that it can't be nurtured further is when I let go. But I try. I keep trying.
Great. It's been a pleasure, Vajanti ji. I mean, this topic is so wide that we can go on. And, your depth of knowledge and the snippets that you have shared, I have found personally very, very, engaging and something to really take back. There are some lovely comments in the chat window, which you must read. Everyone has appreciated this a lot. And I would, request Mansi to please tell us what she felt about the webinar, and also to give the formal vote of thanks.
A very good evening to everybody present in the webinar today.
Hello, Mansi. How are you?
I'm doing good. Vajanti ji, the first thing when you think of branding, the first thing that comes to my mind, at least, would be a very commercial world.
True.
So it's not that I didn't know what personal branding is, but I think I've never been given so much information about it in the past. And I have a confession to make. When we started this meeting today, I was a little under the weather, and I told Snigdha that I'm sorry, I won't be able to put on my camera and I won't be able to give the vote of thanks. And then I realized, and then she said, you know, had you told me a little earlier, I would have asked somebody else to. And then as we just started, I think I put on my camera after a bit of a while. And I said, no, this is not what I am. I have her back and she has my back and I can't do this to Snigdha today.
Fantastic.
So I immediately put on my camera and I said, yes, I have to be there and I have to go there right now. So I guess, yes, I mean, honestly
see,
speaking, I didn't know.
You were there.
I didn't realize it till now. I mean, I've heard of it. I wouldn't say I've never heard of it, but it's just that I didn't think of it so much. And I also feel, I think, you know, if you think of personal branding as what you want people to think of you and what you are, as you said, you can't, you know, you have to be very original. You can't put up with things. It has to come from within. So right. I think over a period of time, maybe we all just become better people, I think.
You do.
I don't know. You would be a better judge at this because you must have come across a lot of people. But it's a nice way when you realize, okay, fine, this is the way I need to talk to someone, or, you know, I need to maintain my tone here. We're very random and radical at times. We don't think of so many things before we speak. But if we are so conscious about everything that we do, I think there'll be a time where we'll be very happy with the way we've turned out to be, or where the kids have turned out to be. And I think it's extremely important. What I take back from today is, honestly speaking, I didn't know so much about it, but what I take back from today is, I take back a lot of information as to what I want out of, what I want people to perceive of me and how important it is. Like in the beginning, I felt it was okay from off the camera.
So yeah, can I sure. add something there? So, sure. you know, Mansi, unconsciously, a data says that we impact more than 75,000 people in our lives, consciously or unconsciously. A data says that. So you have to understand what you're giving out there as a mother, as a healer, what you're giving out there. So when I look at you, Mansi or Snigdha ji, the way you guys are talking. So when I'm going to go back to the day when we first met. So the way you talk, the way you put your tone, the way you put across your thoughts, the way you then manage as leaders to the platform, all of this makes me either stay with MLF or not stay with MLF. So it's like that. So we have to understand, like if you ask me, you can say that, you know, how mechanical that would be to just get conscious about everything that we do. No, you don't need to be mechanical. Just the way we are conscious about our handwriting from a very young age. Similarly, just be conscious that, you know, each and every action and thought and tone and work and do's and don'ts have a ramification. The moment you are conscious of it, trust me, slowly it will develop like a habit, and then you don't need to be conscious about it. So initially, you like the way you said, you'll be the best judge. I used to judge. Now I don't judge. I just tell someone, you know what, he or she is coming from a space, I'm coming from a space, we don't meet anywhere midway. So it's okay. So all of this thing comes through a lot of practice and being conscious. And thank you, Mansi, for actually owning your camera and I could see you. And the smile, so I would have pride of it. So yes, I'm really thankful that the session could be helpful to you.
Yes, thank you so much. I'd like to thank the audience also who pulled out their time, and it was a wonderful session, and I think we've all taken back a lot with us. And I'm hoping, especially if the teens have also not been able to log on, if their parents could take back stuff for them, I think it's a lot of knowledge our kids kind of need to know about also. Yes, as you mentioned about social media and things like that, I think we have to be particular about certain things, and everything has a repercussion too. And we have to be very particular about it. So Thank you so much, Vijayanti ji. Thank you so much. And thank you from MLF.
Thank you. Thank you.
It was really nice having you on board.
It was
thank you, Snake.
Thank you, Mansi. Thank you, Vijayanti.
Thanks, Snake.